All right, guys, so my guys at St. Louis Art Supply hit me up and they were like, yo, Dave, we got something we want you to try out. And I'm like, okay, what is it? And they're like, yo, it's these Faber-Castell watercolor markers. I'm like, watercolor markers? Never tried watercolor markers before. So let's try them out. They were like, come on down, we got you. So took a drive down to St. Louis Art Supply and guess what? They got me. So this is the Faber-Castell watercolor markers. And they even gave me, hooked me up with some Fabriano watercolor paper to try it out on. So, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna unbox this, we're gonna try this out, and we're gonna see what I can create with this. I don't even know what you would call these, because they're not like Copic markers, but they're watercolor markers. They're markers, but they're watercolor. We're gonna find out. So let's get into the unboxing and at least see what this is all about. Guys, so these are the Faber-Castell watercolor markers, and let's just try them out and see what we got. Should have brought the knife, but it's just simple plastic. All right, so right off the bat, that they didn't even make it over to the trash can. It was sad. I wish you guys could have seen it. It was pathetic. But anyway, right off the bat, gotta say, box looks good. Cool looking box. So. Let's open that up and check that out, guys. So we get a nice little this is interesting. It comes with an instruction booklet. I've never seen that before. I'm intriguing. And of course we get all the primary colors. So you've got your red, you know, your yellow, orange, red, blues, greens and browns and black. This is just a basic set, it looks like. So let me check out the instruction booklet here and let's get into creating some art with these and hopefully we can do something dope. You never know. All right, guys, so I just read the instruction booklet and basically it was just going over certain care tips and things like that that you need for these types of brushes or markers. They're brush markers. Markers, because they're markers. That's what they say they are. They're markers. They're brush markers, though. So, and then since they're not like Copics and the fact that they're alcohol-based, Copics are alcohol-based and these, of course, are watercolor markers, so it's a little bit different of a beast. You do have to kind of do a little bit of preparation to try and figure out exactly how these are going to work. And basically, you know, if I mix colors too much and I start seeing residue on the nibs, just clean it off with a paper towel. So I got my paper towel right here. And and it should blend like watercolors. So I'm really interested to see how that's going to go. If you notice, like I said, the guys over at St. Louis Art Supply, and they are sponsoring this video. So this is a sponsored video. If you haven't already, go check them out on the web. You know the website, but I'll make sure it's linked up. If you're out of state, and if you're in state, come down to Central West End and check them out. But they also provided me with some watercolor paper that I can use. And this is, take it out. That's the Fabriano Studio watercolor paper, which is really interesting because I've been researching watercolor paper and this is like one of the most highly recommended ones, and I've been wanting to try these guys out for a minute. So it's gonna be kind of cool. Let's try out the watercolor paper. Let's try out these watercolor markers and let's see what we can create. In fact, I think I'm also going to use my Prismacolor Verathins. I'm going to use my Verathin colored pencils to set up everything, set up the artwork, set up the line work, and then go from there just to see how it works. So let's get into this artwork. Let's create something really dope and let's go from there. We'll be right back. right, guys, so what's my thoughts on the Faber-Castell watercolor markers? Well, that's about the best way I can put it. Let's start off with some of the pros. I actually like the feel of the watercolor markers. They're very, very large, of course, grippable. The nibs seem pretty soft and workable. And the paint, once it was on the board itself, moved around really, really easily and was very, very blendable. I did like that. And I do like some of the blends that I got with it. And some of the colors were really, really bright and really, really vibrant. So I really like those too. Now let's get to the cons. First things first, the colors go on very, very dark. And I'm not sure if that's part of the how you're supposed to use them or not. And the other thing that I, another con or another thing that I just didn't really like is that, okay, you put the paint on there, it's really, really dark to begin with, and then as you try to spread it and lighten it up with a brush, because I was using a separate brush to kind of lighten it up a little bit, it's lightening up, but then it's like thinning out really badly. It's like it goes on really thick, and then you pull it, and then it goes and it's, you know, you get a nice little brown going, you're like, okay, I've got it worked, but then it'll really thin out after that, like, wait, I'm losing. So not a lot, it's like it goes on thick, so you're thinking there's a lot of dye or color there, and it's really not. The other thing is that it's a little bit of chalkiness that I'm kind of not digging. Now that may be because of the board, because this board is a really smooth watercolor paper as opposed to the more toothy kind, so maybe this will work better on a vellum watercolor paper as opposed to a smooth watercolor paper, or I guess you would call it a hot press. Yeah, this is a cold press. So I'm not sure. The other thing that I didn't like is while most of the colors were really, really vibrant, I found the brown, which is probably one of the most important colors to me personally, I found the brown to be just not, it was, nah, son, nah, I wasn't feeling it. It's, I have very specific needs for brown, because I do a lot of brown people. Of course, I'm black, I'm African-American, black, African-American, whatever you want to call me, and I do a lot of black people, brown people, and so I'm very, very sensitive to the browns that I use, and the browns that I get. One of the reasons why I like Copics is because their browns really, really hit. They just hit. They hit dope. One of the reasons why I like the Van Gogh watercolors that I use is because that brown, it hits. It works. You know, my people pop. They look good. They're bright, vibrant. They feel alive. This one, Faber-Castell, you might want to look at what you're using for your dyes, for your browns, because wasn't it, son? Wasn't it? This one is duller for some reason, kind of on the gray side, and it just wasn't feeling it, and that's off rip. So, you know, use a brown and off rip, you're not feeling it, you're kind of going to go downhill from there. Now, the yellow, on the other hand, was super bright and super vibrant, really, really nice, so I could use that. And then the other thing that I really, really didn't like, honestly, was that I had to use a brush to thin out or blend the colors, and I didn't understand why that was necessary, because I thought the whole purpose of having a watercolor marker was so that you could get that watercolor feel and do the blends and all that without having to use a brush. And maybe I was using it wrong, maybe it was user error, I don't know, but it wasn't working for me, and I'm a little disappointed, because I was really looking forward to using these markers, and I really, really thought they would work out well, but it just wasn't hitting for me. So what I personally recommend these guys, can't do it, guys, can't do it. Now, that being said, some artists may come in, grab these, and it works perfectly fine for them, and you know what? That's what's up. I would say, hey, to each his own. But for me personally, just my experience, it wasn't giving me enough to make me say, yo, these are it. It just wasn't giving me enough. So can't recommend them. Wish I could, but I really can't. But gotta give fat shout outs to my guys over at St. Louis Art Supply that wanted me to try these out to see what I thought about them, give them a recommendation if I thought they were a go. And I definitely look forward to trying out some other art supplies thanks to them. So this one wasn't the one, but you never know, might get another one, which will be the one. And I'm looking forward to trying it out. But that being said, guys, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, and if you are, please subscribe to the channel. I'd love for you to join our community. And all of you guys, please hit that bell icon. That's going to let you know when we're going to have new videos up. I post new videos every Monday and Friday, but just in case you forget, the bell lets you know. All right, guys, if you want to get in touch with me, of course, just holler at me on Instagram or Twitter at DKG72. Check out my Patreon. And of course, if you want to holler at me even more, I'm on the Facebook I'm on my Facebook fan page, David Gordon 72. All right, guys, to the next video. I'll holler at y'all later. Hey.